into your hands. I command my spirit.
We are thankful to God for this wonderful weather, and also thanks for all coming in large number. This is the first time that we are doing Living Stations of the Cross here, and we have a trailer here. Those who cannot able to walk, it's a half a mile from Station 1 till we reach the Rock Chapel. So let us begin as Living Stations of the Cross. I ask you, Lord, keep watch over our decisions. Bring them clarity by your light and lead us to ask the right questions, evil alone, never doubts. Trees that sink their roots in the ground, wither if watered by evil. But you have set our roots in heaven and our branches on earth to know and follow you. Amen. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Carrying it on your shoulders. How many times have I rebelled in anger against burdens I have received, viewing them as heavy or unjust? That is not your way. You are only a few years older than I. Nowadays, we would consider you still young, but you are accepting. You take seriously what life offers you, every opportunity it presents, as if you wanted to go to the very heart of things, to discover that there is always something beyond appearances, something remarkable and meaningful. Thanks to you, I understand that this is a cross of salvation and liberation, a cross that bears me up whenever I stumble, a yoke that is easy, a burden that is light. The scandal of the death of God's Son, a sinner's death, a criminal's death, grants us the grace to discover amid sorrow your resurrection, amid suffering your glory, and amid anguish, your salvation. And the cross itself, which speaks to us of humiliation and pain, is now revealed thanks to your sacrifice.
That in the light of the cross, the symbol of our faith, we may accept our sufferings and, enlightened by your love, embrace our own crosses, made glorious by your death and resurrection. Give us the grace to look back on the story of our lives and to rediscover in them your love for us. Amen. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus was praying that if it were possible, this hour might pass him by. He kept saying, Father, you have the power to do all things. Take this cup away from me, but let it be as you would have it, not as I. Mark 14:35-36. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. Isaiah 53:4. Let's meditate. I see you, Jesus, making your way to Calvary, bearing our sins. I see you fall, hands and knees on the ground in pain.
Be with me, Lord.
Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved, He said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother."
In meditation, I see you, Jesus, crushed beneath the weight of the cross. I see that you can't do it alone. At your moment of greatest need, you remain alone without those who called themselves your friends. Judas betrayed you. Peter denied you. The others abandoned you. At times, Jesus, we feel like you, abandoned by those we thought were our friends, crushed by a heavy burden. Yet we must not forget that there is a Simon of Cyrene ready to carry our cross. We must remember that we are not alone, and in that realization, we will find the strength to take up the cross of those around us.
Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
He has no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him of no account. Isaiah chapter 53, verses 2 and 3.
Jesus falls for the second time.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
It was our infirmities that he bore, our sufferings that he endured. He was pierced for our offenses, crushed for our sins. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us home. Isaiah 53, verse 4. I see you, Jesus, fall once more before my eyes. On falling again, you show me that you are a man, a true man. And I see you get up again, more resolute than before. You do not get up with pride. There is no pride in your gaze. There is love. And continuing on your journey, getting up after each fall, you proclaim your resurrection.
I see you and hear you, Jesus. As you speak to the women whom you met me on the way to your death. Each day you would meet many numbers of people. You would approach everyone and talk to all. Now you speak with women of Jerusalem, who look at you and weep. I too am one of those women. But you, Jesus, speak words of warning that for me are striking. They are so concrete and direct. At first they might appear harsh and severe, but that is because they are so direct. Meeting your last before the cross, we see once more your boundless love for the least and the marginalized. Women in those days were not considered worthy of being spoken to, whereas you and your kindness are truly revolutionary.
I ask you, Lord, grant that together with the women and men of this world, I may become ever more charitable towards those in need. Even as you were, give all of us the strength to go against the grain and to enter into authentic contact with others, building bridges and not enclosing ourselves in the selfishness, and lead us to the solitude of sin. Amen. Amen.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus said, I solemnly assure you, unless the grain of wheat falls to the earth and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. I see you, Jesus, as you fall for the third time. Twice now you have fallen, and twice you have gotten up. By now, there are no limits to your struggle, Jesus. Now, in this third and last you seem completely overwhelmed. But you want to do so to the very end. Perhaps this is love. What I understand is that it makes no difference how many times we will fall. There will always be one last time, perhaps the worst, the most terrible trial, when we are called to find the strength to endure to the end of the journey.
Be with me, Lord. Be with me, my Lord. When I'm in trouble and I don't know where to go, be with me, Lord.
I see you, Jesus, naked, as I have never seen you before. They have stripped you of your garments, Jesus, and are casting dice for them. In the eyes of these men, you have lost the last shred of your remaining dignity, your one possession on this, your journey of suffering. At the beginning of time, your father had sewn garments for men to clothe them in dignity. Now men strip that garment off your back. I see you, Jesus, and I see a young migrant, his body ravaged, who arrives in a land that all too often is heartless, ready to strip off his garment, his one treasure. Yet there is something we often forget about dignity. It is found beneath your skin. It is part of you, and it will always be with you. All the more at this moment in this nakedness. The nakedness in which we are born is the same as the nakedness with which the earth will receive us in the evening of our lives.
Station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." Luke 23:33-34. You have the strength to bear the weight of the cross, to meet with disbelief, to be condemned from your provocative words. Today we stand barely swallow a critical comment as if every word was meant to hurt us. You did not stop even before death. You believed deeply in your mission and you put your trust in your Father. Today in the world of internet, we are conditioned to everything that circulates on the web. There are times when I doubt even my own words. But your words are different. They are powerful in your weakness. You have forgiven us. You held no grudge. You taught us to offer the other cheek, and you keep going, even to the total sacrifice of yourself.
In my hands, and to act differently, grant that I may be set free from all the fears that, like nails, immobilize me and keep me far from the life you have desired and prepared for us. Amen. 12th station. Jesus dies on the cross.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, while the sunlight failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Having said this, he breathed his last.
Nailed him to a tree.
I see you, Jesus, remaining there on the cross, a man of flesh and bones, with all their frailty, all their fears. How greatly did you suffer? It is an unbearable scene, perhaps because it is so drenched in humanity. The word is the key, the cipher of your journey, filled with such suffering and fatigue. It is your humanity that so often we forget to acknowledge in you and to seek in ourselves and in others. For we are all too caught up in a life ever more fast-paced, blind and deaf to the difficulties and the pain of others. I see you, Jesus. Now you are no longer there on the cross. You have gone back from where you came, laid upon the lap of the earth, upon the lap of your mother. The suffering is now past, vanished. This is the hour of mercy. Your lifeless body continues to speak of the strength with which you faced suffering. The meaning that you gave it is reflected in the eyes of those still there at your side and will always remain there in love, given and received. Before you and before us opens a new life, heavenly life, marked by the one thing that resists and remains unbroken by death, love. You are here with us at every moment, at every step, in every uncertainty, in every shadow. While the shadow of the tomb lengthens your body, held in the arms of your mother, I see you and I am afraid, yet I do not despair. I trust that the light, your light, will shine once again.
And we believe that we will see you when you come. In your glory, Lord, we remember, we celebrate, we believe. Here a million moonlit souls are yearning just to touch you and me here. Gather all your people and hold them to your heart. You, when you come, in your glory, Lord, we remember, we celebrate, we believe. Now we recreate your love, we bring the bread and wine to the weak. Sign of grace and mercy, the presence of your Lord. We remember how you loved us to your death, and still we celebrate, for you are with us here. We remember, we celebrate, we believe.
The tomb was nearby. They laid Jesus there. John 19:41-42. In meditation. No longer do I see you, Jesus. Now all is dark. Long shadows fall from the hills, and the Sabbath lamps light up Jerusalem, outside homes and within. They beat against the gates of heaven, closed and impregnable. From whom is all this solitude?
Jesus.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The concluding prayer. O God, we have seen how you worked our salvation through the sufferings, death, and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Teach us to unite our trials and sorrows to his sufferings and death, so that we may likewise share in the joy and glory of his resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Behold the cross on which was hung life's very Lord, God's darling one. Mary's own babe, so cold and so still, helpless before her on Calvary Hill. Nails in his hands, nails in his feet, a traitor kiss upon his cheek, and his pierced heart now broken in two. Love crucified for me and for you. Eyes that won't see, ears that won't hear, lips that deny the friend one so dear. Slowly he turns and captures your eye, then passes on to Calvary to die. Behold the cross of Christ in our midst. All those who bear his wounds in their flesh, suffering for crimes of mercy and peace, signs of the kingdom on Calvary Street. Behold the cross on which was hung life's very Lord, God's darling one. Mary's own babe, so cold and so still, helpless before her on Calvary Hill.